I'm going to be really nasty to you, as I feel I know you, and I don't know you that well, but as I know you better than I know the others, I'm going to be really nasty to you. I'm going to say you can take away your spirit. And we're just going to take the focus away from him a little bit, and we'll work just a few little exercises on you. So just as you're cantering around, I want you to, so I'm just trying to think, I don't want to be too nasty, and so I'm just trying to think, for a minute, you can put both brains in the inside hand, and with your outside hand, put it behind your inside shoulder. Yeah. Good. And I don't want you to worry about him. I just want you, as you're doing it, a little bit higher with the hand. Good, and take that shoulder down. Now go large and really feel you can just allow the legs to just relax and come longer. Good, even longer in the legs. Now if you're really honest, look up. If you're really honest, do you feel going down the long side that you have to sort of hold on a little bit with one knee and thigh more than the other?
No, right.
Exactly.
I have a contact. Sorry? I have an ear piercing, like a microphone ear piercing.
Oh, I don't mind yelling.
Okay.
I'm fine yelling. I'm not used to such high technology. So just see as you're canting around, you've got to think, okay, what have I got to do that I actually can keep my right thigh and knee softer? Really feel you can let it go. Now to take the hand back on the rein. And come back onto your circle. And you can imagine there's, just keep the shoulders down, look up and imagine there's a stick behind your back. But your shoulders stay down, but relaxed and down. And then I want you to look behind you over your left shoulder. There. Now as you do that, let go of that right knee. Yeah, sorry, I'm getting you confused, I know. Really lengthen through that right leg. And gradually on the circle, I want you to make a smaller circle, but by using your outside aid. I don't want you to come onto your right rein to do it. Just push him round. Good. And then let him come a little bit more forward as you're doing it. So as you're doing it, just allow a little bit more ground cover with the soft right knee. Good. Rein a little bit shorter now. And now nearly think, as you're doing this, you can ride him as if you're a bit more in dressage mode now, you know, so you can think a little bit more about him, but still thinking of lengthening through your right leg. And then I'm going to be nasty, and for 2-3 strides, I want you to take both legs completely away. He mustn't change. Right away with the legs. It's going to hurt you. If it doesn't hurt, you're not doing it right. Good. So you actually sit. You know, you want to feel you can sit on your... You call it butt, don't you, in America? On your backside. And that you can balance on that backside, yeah? Good. Now go... You could do the 5 meter line. And I want, as you come out of the corner, you can nearly think legs away. You know, that you're not feeling as though you're slipping to the outside, or you're not feeling you're needing to use that right thigh and knee in order to keep your balance. Good, and then straight. Oh, sorry, next time you can do, I'm just being nice and letting you do it in canter, because it's more uncomfortable to do.
to go down the long side then?
Yeah, you can go down the long side. A little bit, take away a little bit of the bend in the neck. Now let him come. And I want the head and neck straighter. So, very good change. But that's what it looks like, yeah? I want to work for the real straightness. The real straightness. So can you feel there that the inside hind leg is on a slightly inner track? So I want again, playing through a little bit to the left and think, now allow him to come forward and think that hind leg has got to step under your bottom, not to the inside. There. And feel you can use the inside leg to straighten him without tightening the right thigh and knee. So we want to get the true straightness. A little bit more to the left, but now let him forward. Forward. So when you go to the, we addressed this earlier with Erin, when you want to make a little correction, like or a little feel to the left with the nose or the neck, don't let the canter drop back on you. So you still, as you're making a correction, you're still riding them forward and through, and the hind leg forward and through, rather than backing off the forward movement. Good. Now the next time you can do the same, shorten up the rein a little bit more, and then you can leg yield him, but without too much bend to the left, just leg yield him three strides onto another line. So three strides over to the right. Now straight. Good. That's straight now. That's straighter. And again. Straight. Now leg yield him over. Now straight. Because the actual leg yielding puts you in a better position, yeah? Do it again, and really now you can leg yield all the way across to the other side. And as you're leg yielding, really let go of the right knee and thigh. Over, 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 good, over, soft right knee and thigh, good. Good. And then you can make a transition to trot. Then trot. Trot. That's right. Now shorten up the rein, and I want you not to fight the movement. Allow yourself just to go with the movement, long in the leg. And nearly you've got to think, imagine you've got that left shoulder, imagine that left hand is touching that right shoulder. Because on this rein, Hawley, you get what it looks like on this rein. Like I said to you, right, let's just have a walk a minute. On this rein, on this rein, you can just look a bit there. Okay? And so it's just a bit tight there. It looks like you've got to just open through the more left shoulder. And that's the same when you then come onto the right rein.
Well, that's okay, because I was actually going to call you a little bit later. I have a question for you. Tomorrow,
definitely on the right way. Yeah.
what you've got to do is in your correct gait, is that you still remember to ride the hind leg forward.
Okay. I know it's funny because don't worry about this.
Yeah.
What do you think about that a little bit more? And again that side. So give yourself a chance to feel it. And again this right.
Use the outside rein a little bit more. Good, and round. Good. Little feel to the right. Keep that left hind leg underneath it. Good. To the right. Good. Now straighten it again. A little feel to the right. Allow him to come forward. Good there. Good there. Circle. A little bit to the outside. Outside leg, if you really need to come round more, use the right leg.
Right.
Otherwise, use the inside leg to the right leg. Now let's see a line again, if you want it straighter. That's better. Now go over a couple of leg yield strides. Just there, now straight. You wouldn't see it as much. But you guys can probably see it. Good, and then straight. Leaving the shoulder there. Inside leg to outside leg. That looked better there. Good. And again.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because when you go straight, that's all quite nice, except the quarter's a little bit in front. And then when you go straight, you still that tiny bit, your shoulder's still that tiny bit too much to the right.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what you've got to feel. So that's where I want. Over, allow us a little bit more there. Now go straight. And then a little bit still there. Okay, change the rein and trot over it.
Straight
and trot. Trot, that's all right. Trot, good. Trot, then nice relaxed guy, let's stand. Go on, give him a kick and give him a little kick and that comes up. Not quicker, it's just now balance him a little. Good boy. Long in that leg. That's all right. No, it's just saying long in your leg, in that inside leg. Good. Let him come. So do what you have to do and then get your arms forward. It's not throwing away the contact. It's balance him and then say, right, there's the arm. You know, I'm offering you the arm. I'm offering you, I can say, you know, you express yourself, you dance. Good, dance, let him dance, let him dance. Just think I'm going to allow him to dance a bit more. Doesn't mean quicker, it just means dancing. But you've got to allow him through your body to dance. When I look there, when I look at him there, it's not just you. I think he throws you that way because with the left arm, yeah. Sorry, right arm, he doesn't like to bring that really underneath him. So you've got to make sure you say, come on, it's got to come underneath you. Now let him come a bit more forward. Perfect. That looks straighter. How does that feel?
diagonal. Better come and protect the left shoulder when you go to turn right.
It's been about 32 minutes.
Yeah, you know, like there, you've just got to, even walking, just think of opening your shoulders. So what you want to do is a little exercise. In the morning when you get out of bed, put your hand on the wall like that and step forward and leave the hand on the wall, because that will make you just open the shoulders, especially if you had that fall and that's got a bit tight.
Outside leg.
the back. Equal weight on both seat bones. Soften the knees, soften the thighs. And then straight. Straight. Inside leg to outside rein. So you've got your new left rein as your new outside rein.